Hello, hi, how are you?
I got a selfie stick. The reason I'm doing this is because my friends and I have a Secret Santa thing going, and it is on Saturday. Right now, it's almost Thursday, and I have not put like any thought into what I'm gonna get for my person because I'm really swamped with schoolwork. I have a lot of it, and so I haven't had time to get out. So what I was thinking of doing is Taylor Swift lyrics. This is because my roommate is the biggest Taylor Swift fan I have ever met in my entire life. So basically, it's gonna be like that, except with words. You guys get the gist of me. I've done this before, it seems pretty easy. I don't think it's gonna be that hard with words. The only problem I'm having right now with the words is like, I don't know any Taylor Swift lyrics. So I'm going to have to go search that up right now. Famous Taylor Swift lyrics. You know what? Why don't I just go ask him what his favorite song is right now? I'll be great. You know what? I'll just bring you guys along like a little secret. Jake? What's your favorite Taylor Swift song?
There's too many.
I'm just wondering, what if I was trying to get into Taylor Swift? Wait, what's your favorite song? Okay.
Oh, okay. My favorite Taylor Swift song of all time, also, it's called Queens.
Yeah.
That's my favorite.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a lot slower. It's like a more powerful song.
Mm-hmm.
But it's good.
Well, I'll go listen to that then. All right. Thank you.
What made you decide to get into the One True Queen
University? I was just, I don't know. I was like, you know what? Might as well.
Approve of your choices.
Thank you.
Tell me how you like.
Okay, will do. I got the information. I got the deets. Hi, Hunter. Did you just leave a whole bunch of messy dishes on my table because I was away from my room? Hunter lives in that room. And he's Satan. But it's okay. So those are his two favorite songs. I am going to use Eyes Open because I feel like if I used Clean, it would either be like a banner hanging across his room seeming to state that he is a neat freak, or hey, I'm STD free, which like, I mean, like both are great. I don't think they're necessary to have hanging in your room, so I'm gonna do Eyes Open. I also think that's cool because I can put some eyes on there, I can make it awesome. Yeah. Alright, so these are the materials that you will need. I'll let you guys play around with the types of materials and the colors of things and the ribbons to your desire. So you're going to start off by cutting out the letters that you're gonna use for your banner. It can be as big as you want. I made mine roughly about 5 inches or 13 centimeters tall and about 3 to 4 inches or 8 centimeters-ish wide. These are mine. Oh, so proud. Next, you want to get your material. So I used 4 different colors and patterns, but as I said before, you can use one or you can use more. Do what you want, play around with it, see what you like. For each of your letters, you want to lay it out on the back side of the material. Now, follow me here. So you want to draw the perimeter of your letter as well as an extra perimeter. This extra perimeter should be about 1 centimeter wider than the actual perimeter of your letter. So you can do this by freehand. There's really no need for the outer perimeter to be perfect. And you're gonna wanna do this again with the same letter. However, before you do this, make sure that the second letter is mirrored. So I'll explain this better. So let's say if you're using the capital letter R, you draw it the correct way for the first outline, and then for your second outline, it's going to look like the capital R if you saw it in a mirror. I'm using the capital E. That doesn't really require me to do this, but make sure for your non-symmetrical letters to mirror them. After you make the second outline, cut them both out. Now, take your paper letter and sandwich it between the two material letters with their patterns facing outwards. And this is why you needed to mirror any non-symmetrical letters so that the material faces outwards. Now, take your glue and stick the paper to the material. If you don't have glue, use needles to secure the paper to its outline on the material. You don't want it moving around from its outline. So use a simple running stitch to try and sew as close to the paper or the inner perimeter as possible. The reason I had you make the outer perimeter is so that you can cut it off and have a nice clean line. If you want, you can do a hemming stitch and fold the extra material under or whatever, but this was the easiest and fastest way for me, and plus I liked how handmade the running stitch made it look. So yeah, once you're done sewing around your letter, cut that extra material off. And then, honey, you got yourself a damn fine letter. And repeat this process until all of your letters are done. And the reason the construction paper is sewed into the material is so that you have a more structured letter. Without it, depending on your material, your letters could end up floppy and kind of hard to read. Now, you guys do not have to do this next part, but I am going to make the eye that I put in the middle of my banner. I traced myself an eye using a bowl and a piece of construction paper. I then cut it out, and using various circular things like my needle kit and a mug, I drew the pupil, the iris, and the outline of the iris. I then drew these same circles using the same objects on the backside of three different patterned materials and cut them out. So you will see, this makes up my eye. I placed these materials on the front side of my eye, the side that I didn't draw on, and I did a running stitch along the circumference of each circle to secure them in place to the paper. I drew the outline on the back of the paper to have a line to sew on. And so there you have your completed eye. It looks pretty cool, I really like it. And for eyelashes, I just cut out little 1-inch, like 2.5 centimeter triangles, and then I glued them along the perimeter of the eyeball. And then your eye is complete. So your last task is to attach the ribbon to the tops and bottoms of the letters. You can of course just attach it to the top of the letters, but I chose to do the top and the bottoms because I just like the look. So I used two different ribbons and rolled out 1.5 meters of both. Your length will vary depending on what words you've created and their length. And just make sure to leave about 1/2 foot or 15 centimeters of ribbon on each side so that you can pin it up to your wall when you're done. I ironed out my ribbon and then I flipped my letters around and I pinned them to the back of the ribbons. And don't worry, I'll do a close-up of the pins. I left decently sized even spaces between each of the letters, and I also left a big space in the middle for my eye. And here's a close-up of how I pinned the letters. Now, you need to secure your letters to the ribbon. I suppose you could use a hot glue gun or fabric glue, but I use stitches, you know, because I've been sewing, so you know, just stick to the theme here. And I went over the stitches 2 or 3 times to make sure they were super strong and those letters were not going to fall off. And now you may be done, and for that I do heartily congratulate you, but I have an eye to stick on still. So I laid the eye down and hot glue gunned the edges to the ribbon, and then I flipped it over and I reinforced it by taking 2 ribbons the length of the diameter and glued them crisscross against the back, as well as sewing each of the 4 ends to the main horizontal ribbon. And then that is that! And this is the final result! So yeah, I'm pretty happy with it, I must say. I hope you're as happy with yours as I am with mine. And now, all I have to do is give it to Jake. So apparently I'm super rubbish at Secret Santa, because I immediately told him it was me without him getting to guess. But whatever. I think he enjoyed it. Did you like your new present, Jake?
I love it.
Oh my god. How wonderful. I'm so happy. Alright, so that was the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I hope you guys have a great time making your own. I have a bit of a request. I know that I'm a very small YouTuber, and like I don't expect all of you to do this, but I do care about what you guys are doing. So if you do complete it, can you show me? Like, that would be amazing to know that you guys are out there. It's pretty cool, you know? So I guess the easiest way to do that would be over Instagram. You can direct inbox me on Instagram. You can tag me in the photo. You can use the hashtag VMarieDIY. Yeah, that works. Instagram is the easiest method because, you know, I'm on there. That's my jam. I like Instagram a lot. So that would be super amazing. Like, I'm very interested to see what you guys come up with, because obviously you can do whatever words and whatever sayings you want. So yeah, I believe in you guys. I believe that you're very creative. So yeah, thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'm so happy it turned out great and that you liked it and everything. It makes my heart feel so good. And yeah, I hope you guys are having a great day. If you're not having a great day, I hope it gets so much better. And I will see you guys later in another video. All right, bye.